Welcome to a special Christmas edition of Highway 89, Utah's most scenic musical byway. Ring out, wild bells, to the wild sky, the flying cloud, the frosty light. I'm Tim Slover, and today we journey along a frosty Yuletide highway to a place of joyous, crystalline beauty. I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play. Be of good cheer. Gentle listeners, for the Utah Valley handbell ringers are here. And be of even gooder cheer, because pianist, composer, arranger, extraordinaire David Tolk is in studio too. I couldn't be more thrilled. There's no sound which invokes the season of Christmas, my absolute favorite season, by the way, like the sound of a choir playing English handbells. And we have with us one of the finest handbell ensembles in the country. The Utah Valley Handbell Ringers was founded in 1993 by Kareneskew-Wylie, who's been ringing bells and devoted to handbell music for as long as she can remember. She owns the bells of the choir. She selects the music and trains the ringers and books the concerts. And just in case one of her ringers runs into serious trouble, Karen is also a surgical nurse. There are 56 bells in Karen's collection. I can see them all before me, each tuned to a single note, and each cast in bronze or aluminum. The ensemble also plays 6 octaves of chimes. The Utah Valley handbell ringers have performed in a variety of stunningly beautiful sacred venues, including the Crystal Cathedral in Garden Grove, California, the Cathedral of the Madeleine in Salt Lake City, and the Provo, Utah Tabernacle. They've performed at Disneyland, the Conbrio Music Festival in Park City, the Sierra Center for the Arts, and have rung their bells more than once while marching in parades, which must be a first for a bell choir. The Utah Valley Handbell Ringers have collaborated with the Utah Baroque Ensemble and Nebo Chorale and Orchestra, and also frequently performed to packed crowds at libraries, schools, hospitals, art museums. In many instances, they do this as a gift, free of charge. Tonight, it's an all-Christmas program, starting with a piece which premiered 120 years ago in St. Petersburg, Russia, and has been essential Yuletide music ever since. Thank you. You just heard the Utah Valley Handbell Ringers perform music from Peter Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker in an arrangement by Kevin McChesney. We're celebrating the Christmas holiday here at BYU Broadcasting with a special edition of Highway 89. I'm Tim Slover, and I see before me someone that I think should look much more worn out than you are. You look fresh as a daisy. This is KAREN-ESKEW-WYLLIE, founder and director of the Utah Valley Handbell Ringers. I'm thrilled by what I just saw.
Isn't it a fun piece?
How can everybody do all this all together? I want to talk about so many different things with you, but let's begin by learning about these beautiful bells and how they're played. I see that these ringers have several bells in front of them. It's not just one ringer to one bell.
Correct.
And their technique is amazing. They're not just grabbing a bell and shaking it back and forth, which is kind of what I would do to, you know, summon school to start again or something. How do they play the bells?
Well, it takes a little bit of training. You have to be able to read music, and then you have to have the passion in your heart. That's what it takes.
Okay. Now, there are techniques to this,
there
of
are.
Course.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand that you all are prepared to demonstrate some of these techniques with us. So I'll name a technique, and then maybe you can describe what's happening, and then it could happen.
Okay.
Okay. Let's start with malleting.
Malleting is a staccato sound.
Okay, if somebody hits something, right? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Table damping?
Table damping is you just ring the bell and it's a way to stop the sound.
Oh, she then puts it on the table.
Yes, usually you damp it against your body, but sometimes you have to damp it on the table.
Okay, and we were revealed not how it was done this time.
No.
Okay, how about Mart?
Okay, Mart is also a staccato sound. Do it again. There he goes.
Okay, now that time you hit it against the table.
The table, we have 4-inch pads on the table.
Oh, okay.
So you don't really see that, so that protects the bells.
Okay, kids, don't try this at home with your table.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, but there's also a thing called a Mart lift.
And that actually brings the sound out of the table.
Okay, so you hit the table, but then you hold it up.
And pull it up.
It makes that beautiful sound. Mm-hmm. Shaking? I guess that's pretty obvious.
It is.
She shook the bell.
Right.
Okay. How many different kinds of bells are there?
Handbells?
Yes.
Well, there's two makers in the United States, if that's what you're talking about. There's two companies that make the English handbells.
And where did yours come from?
From Pennsylvania. Both companies are in Pennsylvania.
Is that right?
Yes. I actually got to see them made. So it's kind of
really?
Fun. Really? Mm-hmm. Very interesting.
And I see that many of them look gold in color, and they're made from?
Bronze.
And the silver ones are made from?
Aluminum.
Now, I heard that big bells can be 18 pounds.
If they're made of bronze, and that's why the company that these come from were the ones that actually came up with the aluminum bells.
Okay.
What they needed to find was the exact same tone that came in from bronze to aluminum.
Okay. So the gentleman that's plying those looks like he could handle 18 pounds, but they're probably not quite 18 pounds.
No, these are, what, six pounds, I think?
That's plenty. That's plenty. Can we hear something else, please?
Another song?
Yes, please. We'll be hearing three pieces, I Wonder As I Wander, arranged by Kathy Mockelbust, and then David Tolk, who we'll talk to later, our pianist, will be doing his own arrangement of The Holly and the Ivy. And then the handbell choir will do Fum, 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 a Catalan Christmas carol.
Thank you. Thank you.
That was amazing. You were just treated to the Catalan Christmas carol Fum Fum Fum, arranged by Susan T. Nelson. That was preceded by the gorgeous arrangement of The Holly and the Ivy that David Tolk arranged, who's the pianist in studio this evening. And the set began with the Appalachian carol I Wonder As I Wander. Merry Christmas. This is a special holiday edition of Highway 89 on Classical 89 and Sirius XM 143 BYU Radio. Karen.
Yes.
A few minutes ago, you talked about how as your musicians prepare to learn to play the handbells and then play them, they need to have something in their hearts.
Mm-hmm.
I spent a lot of time in London, and on a few occasions I've had the privilege of climbing the spiral staircase up the northwest tower of St. Paul's Cathedral and watching the change ringing.
Oh,
and
yes.
To me, there's something solemn and joyful at the same time about the sound of those 12 bells.
Yes.
What do you like most about the sound of bells?
It speaks to my soul. It's one of those things, it just, from the minute I heard them, it just speaks to my soul. When I'm down, it sort of calms me down and helps me get through whatever I'm going through. And when it's joyous, it just takes me to the top.
Can you remember some event or some time when you heard a bell and it meant something to you? Was there a bell? Or when you want to get that feeling, do you have recordings?
Oh, yes. Okay. Oh, yes. Lots of recordings.
Where do you get those recordings?
Well, there's lots of... it's funny. A few years ago, you didn't... it's like 10 years ago, there weren't many recordings of handbells, but they've sort of exploded. And now lots of groups are recording, as well as my group has.
Your group, I know mm-hmm. is also recorded, and sometimes even not Christmas music, right?
Oh, yes. We have just hymns as well.
Okay. And Pirates of the Caribbean?
Yes, yes. Show tunes, definitely.
Hymns and Pirates of the Caribbean. Well, can we hear some more of that sublime music now, please?
Not pirates, though.
No, let's have more Christmas music,
okay.
Please. We're going to hear Silver Bells, arranged by Cynthia Dobrinsky, and then it'll be back to David Tolk and his arrangement of Good King Wenceslas, and then the set will be completed by the beautiful O Come Emmanuel by the Utah Valley Handbell Ringers.
Thank you.
You just heard the solemn, starlit Advent hymn, O Come Emmanuel, in an arrangement by Joel Rainey and Arnold Sherman. That was preceded by our own David Tolk's arrangement of Good King Wenceslas. And to start off, Silver Bells, which it would have been a Christmas crime for this handbell choir not to play, in an arrangement by Cynthia Dobrinsky. I'm Tim Slover, and you're listening to a special Christmas edition of Highway 89 on Classical 89 and Sirius XM 143 BYU Radio. Well, David Tolk, you are the pianist of the hour, and I'm a big fan. I have been for a long time. You've released 8 CDs, 2 of which are Christmas albums, and one of the great perks of doing this is every once in a while a kind musician will bring in as a Christmas present his own CD, and I'm honored to have gotten one of those. It's the one entitled Christmas, reached number 8 on Billboard's New Age chart in 2010.
Right.
You also perform regularly in the Big Parade with his good friend, singer-songwriter Peter Breinholt, who has said on the record that you possess, and I quote, unreal musicianship.
Great.
Did I get that right?
I didn't hear him say that, but yeah, I think that's the quote.
That's good, because I know you're also a lawyer. Was there a lot of music making at Christmas time at your house?
When I grew up, when I was growing up, we had a very musical home, and I actually thought that it was normal. In our family, we would sing Handel's Messiah in 4 parts, and we would each have our own book, even when I was little, less than 10 years old. And I thought that was normal, and I brought my fiance home to meet our family, and we did that, and it almost killed the deal. She thought, this is crazy. You know, people don't do this. So it was very musical, and especially around Christmas time, and I loved that.
The arrangements that you've done for us, which are, I would say, on the album, they're so, they bring in so many other textures and things like that. How do you arrange Christmas music? It's so well known. How do you make it your own?
Well, that's a good question. The way that I approach it actually is not to take a Christmas carol and change it. What I do is try to compose a song that works with an already existing carol. So I feel like it's as much a new composition as it is an arrangement of a carol. So I kind of start with original music and then figure out which carol goes well with it, which is fun.
Okay. Has your fiance ever recovered? Did you get married?
Yes, we've been married for more than 20 years now. She did recover, and it seems normal to her now.
Well, thank you very much, and thanks for being here. I just want to also plug your CD, Stories in the Sky, which is all your original compositions. Is that right?
Right. Thank you.
Okay. Well, thank you, because we're now going to hear 2 more pieces, which, if you think about it, seem absolutely tailor-made for this concert. One of them is Carol of the Bells, although that will be played by David Tolk in his own arrangement on the piano. And then the second one will be, wait for it, Ding Dong Merrily on High, in an arrangement by Cynthia Dobrinsky.
Thank you.
You just heard the very sprightly arrangement by Cynthia Dobrinsky of the English carol Ding Dong Merrily on High, performed by the Utah Valley Handbell Ringers, and that was preceded by David Tolk's meditative version of the Ukrainian Carol of the Bells. Well, that concludes tonight's Christmas edition of Highway 89. This hour featured the fabulous musicians of the Utah Valley Handbell Ringers under the direction of Karen-ESKEW-WYLLIE and the amazing and talented David Tolk. Karen, you've really brought the Christmas spirit to us. I think I'm going to go out and finally start my shopping.
Oh, good. As long as we can touch people, because that's what we're all about.
Well, I think you did. You touched a lot of people. And the concentration I see on everybody's faces, and yet the look of joy, I think you've achieved
something amazing. Well, sometimes they forget to smile, and I have to remind them to smile.
Okay, you crack the whip.
I do.
I'm so glad you came today. I'm so glad you brought the bell choir. It can't be easy transporting all of these bells and chimes. So thank you very much.
Thank you for having us, and I hope everyone has a wonderful and safe holiday.
It's been a very merry hour, and each of our musicians is to thank for this. So I'd like to recognize you by name. And as I do, will you each please give us one parting note? Here we go. Our ringers have been Linda Andrus, Sherilee Alford, Abby Bunn, Beth Hansen, Mary Harrington, and Cammie Nelson. Also, Linda Chahal, who's been ringing with the ensemble for 19 years, since the very beginning. And here's some other longtime ringers: Nicole Robbins, Suzanne Sawyer, Stephanie Talley, and Braden Wilhelmson. And new ringers, I like that low one, and new ringers: Kelly Noring, Teresa Carlson, Jackie Whitehead, Mac Whitehead. And at the Steinway, we've been privileged to hear David Tolk. The Utah Valley Handbell Ringers have recorded two Christmas albums, as Karen mentioned, Bells of Christmas and Our Christmas Favorites, as well as CD of hymns and sacred music that can be listened to any time of the year. The Utah Valley Handbell Ringers is a non-denominational ensemble, though the bell choir regularly rehearses in the Provo Adventist Community Center, where space has kindly been provided to store the bells and the ensemble's music library. More information about the bell choir is available at Utah Valley Handbell Ringers, that's all one word, utahvalleyhandbellringers.com. We welcome your comments, questions, and holiday wishes. For more information about this show, simply email us at highway89@byu.edu. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting in Provo, Utah. Our tireless production elves are recording engineer Mark Waite and producer Jackie Tataishi. I'm Tim Slover, reminding you, please, don't drink eggnog and drive. And from all of us at the studio here, a very Merry Christmas.